So today we're going to be looking at grip tape for drag clicking and which one is the best and if Razer grip tape or Chloris grip tape is actually worth it to buy. And why would you trust me? Well, I have Razer grip tape myself, I know how it works. I also have other tapes so I can compare those. And I can drag click myself, I've gotten pretty high CPS and I can gobridge. So, no, I'm not the best at all of those, but I know how to do it. So yeah, before we start, make sure you're subscribed. You could be my 1 million subscriber. Who knows, maybe 990,000 people subscribe at the same time. So yeah, I wouldn't risk it. So what is tape actually supposed to do? Well, when you put tape in your mouse button, it will make it so you can get more friction on your mouse button. And if you drag your finger over your mouse button, it will make it way easier to drag click. And a lot of people found out about Razer grip tape because this popular YouTuber Intel Edits made a video about it and showed that you could drag with the tape and couldn't without. By the way, if you drag your finger over your mouse button without tape and you can feel like your finger vibrates because of the friction, you should be able to drag click fine without tape, and it's going to give you less CPS if you do put tape on it because it adds friction. More about that later, but just keep that in mind. So back to the Razer grip tape, it adds way too much friction in my opinion. It was fine for short drag clicking. I even made a video that did really well with Razer grip tape, and that was the first time I could actually gobridge. But if I tried long drag clicking, which is basically using my whole mouse button to drag click, I only got like 6 CPS per drag, and this was on my Model D's. And I took the tape off by now and I can get 20 CPS without tape just fine. And this is different for everyone, of course. Some people can get 20 CPS with the tape just fine, but is it really worth it? I looked up the prices for both Razer and Chloris grip tape, and they cost about $10, so that's a lot for just one piece of tape to drag click, and there are way cheaper ways and better ways for doing so. Also, my Razer grip tape loses friction because of oils on your fingers and stuff, and I saw people cleaning it with alcohol, but it didn't really work for me, or at least not as good as at the start. So what do you have to buy then? Flex tape?
That's a lot of damage!
Well, no, Flex tape is really expensive, and this one legend even made a video on it. It'll be in the description, by the way, but the conclusion of the video is basically that Flex tape is really bad to drag click on. So in my opinion, you should get like electrical tape. Some people even have this at home already, but do not use it, as I said, if you can already drag click without tape, because tape may make it easier to drag click, but you will not get as high CPS, doesn't matter what tape. So electrical tape is really good for me at least. I even found 20 meters of electrical tape, which is 66 foot by the way, for like €2 in a local store, which is $2.50. So yeah, a lot of people also like masking tape or painting tape or paper tape. I think that's all the same, just a different name. I had this at home already because we painted our house this summer and it worked for me, just not as good as electrical tape, but I've seen people where masking tape is working better for them, and that's completely fine. And a big advantage of the electrical tape or the masking tape is that if it loses the friction, you can just cut another piece of the tape and put it in your mouse. And it's also very easy to take off the mouse, unlike Razer grip tape. And that's really good because you don't want to rip off your whole mouse button while changing the tape. Another way to do this is to make your fingers sticky. Maybe with this you can drag click without tape. And the first thing you can do is make them a bit wet. This doesn't really work for me, but it does for some people. You can also like sweat, and this works for me, but it isn't really recommended. And the last thing is to rub some tape over your finger to get some glue on your finger. This also works really well for me, and it's better than sweaty fingers. So what is the conclusion of this video? So the best option is always no tape, because this will give you the most CPS and you don't always need to change the tape if it loses the friction. But if this doesn't work, maybe try the previous tip, which makes your fingers sticky, or use electrical tape or masking tape. And if you're really rich, you can try out Razer grip tape or Chloris grip tape, but this is not really recommended as it is really expensive. And never buy Flex tape, please, it's really bad, okay? Anyways, I hope you learned something. I tried to make it as understandable as possible. Let me know what you think or give me some feedback on how I can improve my videos. And yeah, I hope I'll see y'all next time. Bye!